We haven't seen much of AI being used by cyber criminals because most of the breaches that we see are more due to the fact that the companies failed to implement best security practices or basic security controls. However, that is, of course, going to change as implementing AI becomes easier and there is more saturation into the market, and then we are going to look at more and more attackers utilizing AI in their attack techniques. With that being said, one of the examples of AI and one of the utility is something that is known as deepfake. So you have generative adversarial network GAN, whereby you have two machine learning algorithms fighting with each other, competing with each other. So you have a generator whose purpose is to generate, let's say, fake images, which would look really real. And you have a discriminator whose purpose is to detect the images that have been generated by, the generator. So as we go into these iterations, both systems get better at learning and detecting and cheating. And what you have as a result of it is something that is known as deepfake. We have started looking at extortion campaigns on the basis of attackers using deepfake technology to create a video or an image of a victim in a questionable manner. And then, of course, demand payments in bitcoins. That is something that is getting better. These algorithms are getting better. And therefore, this is something that we are going to see for foreseeable future. The other example would be Microsoft Twitter bot, which was basically victim of something that is known as machine learning poisoning. The way these machine learning and AI algorithms work specifically is they are trained by the use of large data set. So for instance, in a scenario where you would like to detect spam, you would give the machine learning algorithm a set of emails that are classified as, let's say, spam, and a set of emails that are not spam. So the machine learning algorithm, what it would do, it would find similarities between all the emails, that are classified as spam. And then, of course, by using multiple iterations, you would have what would be known as a black box model. So when the machine learning model is operational, it learns from the inputs that is received. So for instance, when the Twitter bot was activated, it was learning from the tweets that people were tweeting. Therefore, it had developed some systematic bias, and it reached to a point whereby, of course, it was trained in a certain way to behave in a certain manner, but of course its machine learning was poisoned by the use of malicious tweets, and therefore it started tweeting weird stuff and Microsoft had to take it down. However, we haven't seen these attacks at large scale. We have seen academic research around that, but we are yet to see it at the large scale because, of course, it requires a lot of resources. And there are better and much easier ways to deceive spam filters. With that being said, AI is being used by the defenders, mostly cybersecurity companies, using AI and machine learning to detect attacks. Security incident event management tools such as LogRhythm, QRadar, ArcSight, solutions like Darktrace and Cisco's StealthWatch using a combination of supervised and unsupervised machine learning algorithms to detect anomalies in your network. These days, it's very difficult to create a product that would give the customers real world value in terms of protecting their assets if it's not using AI or machine learning. For example, if you're an antivirus company, and you are collecting hundreds of thousands and even millions of virus samples every day, it's not possible that those virus samples could be analyzed by human experts. So therefore, you develop machine learning algorithms to detect the new samples and train your model accordingly. Now, antivirus is one example. So next generation firewalls have started to use machine learning algorithms. We have more and more SIEM solutions dubbed as next generation SIEM solution using AI and machine learning. We have endpoint detection response systems using machine learning. So, having machine learning does not mean it solves your problem, because the efficacy of the machine learning algorithm depends upon the data set that it has been used to train and its exposure to multiple environments. A lot of these machine learning models are trained using smaller subset of test data, not the real world data. So what it means is that when it is exposed to the real world environment, it produces a lot of false positives. And of course, it is producing false positive. It has classified something as a malicious critical attack, whereas it isn't. Of course, it is going to wake up your CISO at 3 a.m. in the morning. So that is, of course, been the problem with a lot of these tools that are claiming that they are using machine learning algorithms, but their models are not well trained. And cybersecurity data is very difficult data because if you look at subsets and data sets like weather forecasting and forex data set, these are very complex data sets. And the AI is not that efficient. The same is the case with cybersecurity. However, we have seen a lot of AI being used in EDR, endpoint detection and response systems, whereby they have been pretty successful.